All it takes is a quick look at the nearly empty departures screen here to see COVID-19's impact on the Detroit Metro Airport, generally one of the busiest in the country. Now the big question for airlines, airport businesses, and travelers alike, how long will it take to rebound? Check-in counters still quiet today at DTW, a major economic influence on the state and specifically the Detroit region, says the head of the Detroit Regional Chamber, Sandy Barua.
It is about $8 billion a year, and that has about 80,000 jobs attached to it.
He's optimistic travel will resume, it just may take a while. The Wayne County Airport Authority has not furloughed any workers. However, airport businesses are mostly shuttered. Of DTW's 51 stores, 39 are closed, and of its 52 restaurants, 46 are closed right now. Friday, Wayne County Executive Warren Evans said projections for fees related to the airport look grim in the next year.
Clearly now, the hits on and revenue reductions on airline parking.
Major airlines, including Delta, which has a hub in Detroit, have reported significant losses in the first 3 months of 2020. Last week, the FAA announced more than $27 million in grant money going to DTW for runway work.
15 of those $27.5 million are what we call discretionary funds. The other part were the entitlements of the airport based upon prior passenger traffic.
Last March, around 3.2 million travelers passed through DTW. This March, it's down by more than 50% to only 1.5 million. But Barua says that number is likely to shift even further south.
For the month of April, I think we can all expect air travel across the country, including at our airport here in Detroit, to be down in the 95% range.
The Wayne County Airport Authority says they'll have that information in the coming weeks. Reporting from the Detroit Metro Airport, Jen Schantz, 7 Action News.
Thank you, Jen.